is Joey Fatone. It's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
Thank y'all for coming. Hey, welcome to Family Feud, everybody. I'm your man, Steve Harvey, and we got a good one for you today. Returning for the second day from Alpharetta, Georgia, it's the Belling family. And out of Chicago, Illinois, my new hometown, it's the Brown family. Let's get it on. Give me Bob. Give me Sherman. Folks, here we go. We've got the top six answers on the board. Name a place you wouldn't want to hear your father say he met your mother. Bob.
Strip club.
At the strip club. One answer, Thompson, Sherman.
At the bar.
At the bar.
Mr. Harvey, we're gonna play.
They're gonna play. They're gonna play. Well, Miss Wilma?
Yes.
Miss Willa? I'm sorry.
That's
name
okay.
A place you wouldn't want to hear your father say he met your mother.
At the police station!
Yeah! Yeah! The police station!
Come on, baby! Is that right? Yes.
This is pumpkin. P-U-K, P-U-N-K, pumpkin.
Yeah.
Like I'm punking you? This Miss Pumpkin. See, y'all thought it was Miss Pumpkin. But we all know how we talk when we come.
Amen. That's right.
All right, Miss Pumpkin, here we go. Name a place you wouldn't want to hear your father say he met your mother.
At a funeral home. Yes!
Hey, baby. Get up. Come on. We'll take you out.
Get out,
Get out,
home.
Oh, this is...
All right, come on, Tick. Come on, Tick.
How you doing, my friend? Did you say come on, Tick?
That's right.
Short for lunatic.
Lunatic. There you
they
go.
They call you Tick.
Yeah.
Punkin and Tick.
That's all right,
Dick. Hey, let me tell y'all something. I am enjoying these family right now. Because if this ain't my family standing in front of me. They've been asking me about doing a celebrity family feud. There's no way I can bring my family on this show.
That's right.
I don't have five of my family members I can expose to national TV. But they made it. Tick, you gotta be careful. We got two strikes. The Belling family can steal.
Unemployment office.
At the unemployment office. Bob, here's your chance, man. Name a place you wouldn't want to hear your father say he met your mother.
Prison.
In prison.
Three.
Let's move on to question two. Give me Kim. Give me Willa. Let's go.
Oh, how you doing?
Top seven answers are on the board. Name something people have to have three times a day. Kim.
Food.
Pass or play?
We're gonna play.
They're gonna play, Miss Willie. Woo! Joe, how you doing, man?
Sir. Good to see you.
Let's do it, man. Name something some people have to have three times a day.
A bathroom break.
A bathroom break. Okay, Kim, name something some people have to have three times a day.
Sex. Woo, good answer.
Sex! All right, let's go. Name something people have to have three times a day.
How about a cigarette break?
A cigarette break? All right, Bob, let's go, man. Name something some people have to have three times a day.
Not at my age, but some people have to have a nap three times a day.
Some people have to have a nap. A good answer. Only one strike. Hi, Kim. How you doing today? You have only one strike. Name something some people have to have three times a day.
I say caffeine.
Yeah.
Caffeine, yeah. Only one strike, Joe. What do you think it is? Name something some people have to have three times a day.
Shots. Medicine. Shots.
Yes.
Shots. Medicine. Shots. Hey, Kim, only one answer left. If it's there, you clear the board.
Exercising.
Yes.
Good answer. Good answer.
Exercising. You got two strikes, darling. You got to be careful. The Brown family can steal.
A drink of alcohol.
Yeah! Wow. I like it.
A drink of alcohol. Sherman?
Yes, sir.
Here's your chance. I think we all know the answer, but name something some people have to have three times a day.
Mr. Harvey.
Please, if you don't say
they have
this,
to have.
If you don't say this. We'll be right back. Hey, welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Brown family, 91. Belling family got 60. Give me Joe. Give me Bucky.
How are you, dear?
Woo! Yes! Yes!
Point values have doubled. Here we go. Top six answers are on the board. Name something that follows the word pork.
Lawn.
Huh?
Lawn, pork lawn. L-I-O-N, lawn.
Oh.
Pork lawn.
Glad you spelled it, because I'm... The hell is a pork lawn? I thought you said lawn like the grass outside. I was going, what the hell is a pork lawn? Lawn! Looking for the pork lawn. Joe?
Pork belly.
Pork belly.
We're gonna play! We're gonna play!
We're gonna play?
We're gonna play!
We're gonna play.
Yes! Oh, Lord.
What am?
Name something that follows the word pork.
You pine.
Huh?
Huh? You're fine. Pork is fine.
Good answer! Good answer! Good answer! Yes! That's right, Jack! Yes! Lunatic!
Pork. He said, cupine. Cupine! What? What is cupine? This is the greatest answer I've ever heard.
You can
no, no, I'm feel you. No, I feel you.
Number one.
I feel you. It's number one.
Oh, my mom.
Pow. It's number one. Oh, really? Well, I tell you what, it's gonna be number one on YouTube, but it ain't gonna be number one on there. I bet every dollar I got. You the only person that said cupine. Cupine! All right, Marquise, let's go. Name something that follows the word pork.
Chop!
Yeah!
Chop!
Pork! Chop!
Yeah!
All right, only one strike, Pastor.
Roast.
Pork. Roast.
Yes! Yes!
Willa, hi.
Hi, how are you?
You got two strikes. You got to be careful. The Belling family can steal.
Portees! Portees!
Come here,
Portees! In the horn!
That's in the horn!
NASA!
Portees!
Eat up, baby!
Don't worry about that. Bob?
Yes, sir.
Name something that follows the word pork.
Great snack, pork rinds.
Yeah!
Pork rinds, that's what you meant. Pork rinds. That's what y'all meant right there. Number six. Number two. Don't go away. Play well. We'll be back. Find out who wins it. Hey, welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. The Belling family, 202. Brown family got 91. Give me Kim. Give me Will. Let's go. Folks, here we go. The point values have tripled. We've got the top four answers on the board. Name something people put under a pillow. Will.
Teeth.
Teeth.
Yes! Yeah!
Will, wait, they're gonna play.
Come on, let's get it!
Let's get it! Let's get it! Yes!
All right. All right, Marquis, this is important, so let's just go. Name something people put under a pillow.
Money.
Yes!
Money! Name something people put under a pillow.
A weapon.
Yes. A weapon.
Get out,
get out. A weapon.
Come on. Come on. Let's do it.
Willa,
yes.
If it's there,
yes.
Your family wins the game.
Come on.
Jerry!
Punkin, here's the deal. It's only one strike. Name something people put under a pillow.
A book, Steve! A book!
Good answer!
A book! They read a book!
Good answer!
Good answer! They put a book under there! Yes!
Good answer!
Yes! A book!
A book!
Okay. That's all right. Come on.
Tick is always tough when it gets back to the person that jumped it off. So let me tell you how big this is, Tick. If it's not there, the Belling family can steal, and they win the game.
Food.
Good answer!
Good answer! Good answer! Good answer!
Good
answer!
Food!
That's all right, hold on!
Bob, here's the deal, Bob. If it's there, your family steals and wins the game. Name something people put under a pillow.
Condom.
For the win, a condom.
Yeah!
need two players. Come on. Who's going out here? All right. Cupine, here we go. Hey, welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Brown family won the game. Drive away in a brand new car.
All right,
you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Let's go, man. Name a sport that can be played both indoors and outdoors.
Tennis.
Name something people unroll.
Tissue.
Name something that little kids do in the snow.
Shovel.
At what age does a person start to shrink?
40.
Name the fruit you like most in summer.
Orange.
Okay. All right, let's go. I said, name a sport that can be played both indoors and outdoors. You said, tennis, it can happen. Survey said.
All right.
Uh-huh.
Good.
Name something people unroll. You said, tissue. Survey said.
Yeah.
Name something little kids do in the snow. You said shovel. Survey said. Little Bobby and Tommy go outside, top of all that playing, shovel that snow.
Damn.
At what age does a person start to shrink? You stunned America with this one. You said 40. Survey said. Name the fruit you like most in summer. You said an orange. Survey said.
Good.
Orange. Good go. Okay. Well, let's bring out Sherman. Okay, Sherman. Listen to me.
Yes, sir.
We got a little uphill battle we got to get through here, but you can do it. You want me to tell you how many you need? Almost all of them. You ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's remind everyone of Will's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. All right, here we go. Name a sport that can be played both indoors and outdoors.
Soccer.
Name something people unroll.
Carpet.
Name something that little kids do in the snow.
Snowman.
At what age does a person start to shrink?
50.
Name the fruit you like most in summer.
Watermelon.
Yeah! All right, let's go. I said, name a sport that can be played both indoors and outdoors. You said soccer. Survey said.
Yeah!
Basketball was the number one answer. Name something people unroll. You said carpet. Survey said. Toilet paper was the number one answer.
All right.
Name something that little kids do in the snow. You said, make a snowman. Survey said,
yeah.
Throw snowballs and build a snowman. Tied for the number one answer. We need 75 points. At what age does a person start to shrink? You said, 50. Survey said, number one answer was 60. We need 63 points. Name the fruit you like most in summer. You said watermelon. Survey said.
Yeah!
Watermelon was the number one answer. Man, they could have had that. Well, that's $5 a point for a total of $935, but they're coming right back on Family Feud. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks.